In 1959, eager to end years of losing, the Green Bay Packers hired an up-and-coming assistant coach from New York named Vince Lombardi to make them winners.
Winning isn't everything, but it's the only thing. In our business, there is no second place. Either you're first or you're last.
Tireless in his pursuit of perfection, Lombardi became a revered yet enigmatic character.
Coach Lombardi is probably the most hated man in professional football. I mean, every coach wants to beat Lombardi more than any man.
I think I'm in a tough business, and I think there's only one way to coach that business, and that's to be as hard as the business is.
Everybody grab it out there. Nobody tackle it. Just grab it, everybody. Grab, grab, grab. Nobody tackle it.
I hated his guts. He had the reputation of going to church every day. I didn't believe it, so I went to Bart Starr. He said, oh, no, he goes to church every day. He goes to Mass every single morning. But, Bill, there's something you need to realize. This man needs to go to church.
I didn't think of what them morale was. I didn't come in and have a meeting with the players and say to myself, I wonder what their morale is going to be. I wonder how they're going to accept me. I said to myself, they're going to have to accept me. I'm not worried about their morale. I'm worried about Vince Lombardi's morale.
He did make the point that he had never been associated with a losing team, and he wasn't about to lose at Green Bay. And he said, gentlemen, we're going to win one way or the other.
Come on, look at me, 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 look at me.
9 seasons and 5 NFL titles later, the Packers were pro football's greatest team, and Lombardi, its greatest coach.
If you look at this play, what we're trying to get is a seal here and a seal here and to try to run this play in the alley.
I've never felt that I was complacent or my team was complacent, if you want to call it that. I never lost my desire to win, you know. I don't think I was ever filled up with myself. I think championships are there to be won. And the fact that you win one, or you win two, or you win three doesn't mean to say that you should be filled up now. I think you should win as many as you can, and every time you go out there, you should try to win.
I think after all these years, Mike, that I could come out here and be nice and relaxed. Jeez, I'm a nervous wreck.
Football's in his blood. He can't do without football. He lives it, he dreams it, he eats it, and football is his life. That's his life.
Winning the first 2 Super Bowls sealed his legacy. But perhaps his greatest victory came in the 1967 NFL Championship against Dallas. Played under brutally cold conditions, the game known as the Ice Bowl came down to the last seconds.
Starr begins the count, takes the snap, he's got the quarterback, he's into the touchdown, the Packers are out in front, and the Green Bay Packers are going to be world champions, NFL champions for the 3rd straight year.
Though he was only 57 when he lost his life to cancer, Vince Lombardi lives on in the Super Bowl trophy that bears his name.